In this tutorial, I'll be counting down my top 5 Adobe Firefly prompts for some of the coolest AI text effects.
Studio Shepherd.
At number 5, we have this fluffy candy floss text effect. Great for the local fair or candy shop promotion. So in Adobe Firefly, type the prompt, pink candy floss, fluffy, floating, isolated on a white background. Then click generate. Select the image that you like, and we're going to hover over this pencil here and click use as style reference. And that's going to add it onto our left hand panel here. Now we're going to change the aspect ratio to 16:9. And we're going to add our reference image. So that's the image that we created before. And here, just click continue. Bump the strength slider up to full. And if we scroll down here, we're just going to select hyper-realistic. And then we're going to hit generate. Now we're going to get 4 initial options so we can see how it turns out. And I'm just going to adjust the prompt. So I'm going to change some of this text here, so isolated on a studio background, and a pink candy floss tube. And I'm also going to drop the style reference strength slider down to 0. Then hit generate again, and hopefully you should get something looking like this. So if you don't like any of these options, what we can do is simply hit generate again to create 4 new options. And I'm now liking the look of this one, so we can go up and hit upscale, and that's going to create a high fidelity image that we can then download. And that's how to create this candy floss text effect. At number 4 is this gummy text effect, another cool effect for a candy shop poster. So we're going to use the prompt, single colorful tube on a pastel background, hyper-realistic, reflection, bioluminescent, neon, and press generate. And it's going to create a few images for us to choose from. So what I'm going to do now is adjust some of the settings. So in the left-hand panel here, I'm just going to change the aspect ratio to 16:9, select photo for content type, and then down the bottom here, I'm going to change the lighting to backlighting. So again, we're going to go down and click generate. Cool, and it's created 4 images for us. And I think we can do better, so I'm going to hit generate one more time and see what we get. Cool. So I think this one is working well. So when you find one that you're happy with, we're going to go and select edit. And then we're going to use this as our style reference. And now in the left-hand panel again, we're going to scroll up to the structure reference. We're going to click this thumbnail here and load in the text that we created earlier. So just click open and continue here. And now make sure the strength is set to full, and you can play around with these sliders here to get the best look. I'm going to go for something like this and then click generate. And so what that's doing is using our text that we created earlier is the structure reference, and then it's going to use the style from the image that we created earlier. So this is looking really good. It's creating some nice gummy looking textures, so I'm really liking the look of some of these. So you can click to see the more. You can even see some of the textures coming through quite nicely. So once you're happy, find one that you like, and then what you can do is click download. That's going to create a copy of it for you. And then what I like to do to get even better results is actually use this as the style reference and then click generate, and it's just going to create more iterations for you to choose from. Cool, so again, this is looking good, and there's a few more variations to choose from. At number 3, we have this realistic paint text, perfect for any art class poster. So in Adobe Firefly, use the prompt, bold, glossy red paint smear with dynamic streaks,
Smear with a palette knife on a white background, hyper-realistic. Then click Generate.
So I'm just going to change a few settings in this panel. So I'm going to change the content type to photo and make sure auto is turned off. And if we slide down, I'm going to select hyper-realistic and change the lighting to studio light. After that, I'm going to hit generate again. Cool, and there's a few nice options in here. So if there's one you like, but you want a few more options to choose from, you can click this little pencil here and go generate similar. It's going to create three more that look like this one. So I quite like the look of this one. It's got some nice texture and it's nicely isolated in the frame. So you can download this to make a copy. And then what I'm going to do is by selecting this pencil, I'm going to use this as our style reference. So you'll see that's now appeared in our settings under styles. And what we can also do is upload our structure reference. So this is our text that we created earlier. So I'm going to open that, click continue, and make sure the strength slider is set to full. And then for styles, I like them around the midpoint there. I'm also going to change the aspect ratio now to widescreen and then click generate.
And hopefully you get an option that looks like this. At number two, we have a melting ice cube text effect. Great for that summer party. For this, use the prompt melting ice cube with trapped air bubbles, water droplets, and a thin reflective puddle.
Then click generate, and it's going to come up with four options. Now we're just going to change a few of the settings. So I'm going to select hyper realistic, change the lighting to studio light, and the camera angle to shot from above. And I'm just going to add on the prompt, isolated on a studio background. And then click generate and let's see how this looks. So very similar. So we're going to make a few more changes to our prompt. So I've selected shot from above, but we're still not getting that effect. So in the prompt, I'm just going to add top view. And I'm also actually going to change the studio background to a light blue. And then click generate. Now this is looking a lot better. So I'm liking the look of this top right one. And I think it's going to work well. So I'm happy with that. So I'm going to download that for later. And also clicking this pencil, we can use this as the style reference. So in the left-hand panel, we're going to adjust a few more settings. So we're going to change this to widescreen 16:9 to match our canvas. And then we're going to go down to the composition reference and select our image that we made before. So add that in, press continue here, and we're going to bump up the strength slider to full. And then under style, we're going to drop that one to 0. Now the rest of these settings are still looking good. So we're just going to go and hit generate.
And you should end up with some cool images like this. At number one, my personal favorite and producing some of the coolest results are these metal text effects that can be used for all sorts of mock-ups, posters, or artwork. So we're going to start with the prompt,
forged iron ball with visible hammer indents isolated on a white background, and then click generate, and it's going to create these four variations. Now we're just going to adjust a few other settings on the left hand panel here. So I'm going to change content type to photo, select hyper realistic, change the lighting to studio light, and the camera angle we're going to select shot from above. Now click generate again, and now this is the look that we're trying to go for. So select one that you like. So I might select this one here, and click this pencil, and we're going to use this as our style reference. So that's going to edit on the left hand panel here, and now under our composition reference, click this thumbnail, and then select the text that we made earlier. So I'm going to open that, press continue. I'm going to make sure the strength slider is set to full. And I'm going to drop the visual intensity down to 0 and the strength of the style down to 0. Now I'm also going to change in the prompt, forged iron bull. I'm going to remove bull as we're now working with text. And I'm also going to change the aspect ratio to 16:9. Now click generate and it's going to create these awesome looking metallic text effects. Now I'm going to show you another example with a different prompt and different image. So in the prompt bar, this time we're going to use this prompt here. Rusty metal bowl, corroded edging, isolated on a white background. Then click generate. And following the same steps, we're going to update these settings on the left-hand panel. And click generate again. And so I like the look of this one. So again, I'm going to use this as our style reference. And we're going to drop the strength and visual intensity down. Change the aspect ratio to 16:9. And this time for our composition reference, we're going to use the first text that we created, which was just our flat text. Open that. Bump the strength up to full. And now let's see how that looks. Oh, one more thing. We're going to remove bull from our prompt and then press generate. Now it's going to create some cool, rusty looking text. Now following the same steps, you can play around with the prompts displayed on screen to create different metallic effects. Feel free to play around with the prompts to create some new and unique looks. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest design tips. I'll see you in the next video.